A dream is a dream when we dream it alone. But a dream will become a dream together in reality. This was proved by a distinguished scientist from our country, Dr. Mylswamy Annadurai. He joined ISRO in 1982 and began his career at URSC as a team leader to design and develop software satellite simulator. During the period 1992 to 2005, Dr. Annadurai was the lead member of ISRO satellite mission and managed 8 INSAT missions as the mission director and brought about the efficient ground automation for satellite operations. As project director, Dr. Annadurai made the most crucial contribution to the realization of India's first lunar mission, Chandrayaan 1, which won many appreciations and awards, including the prestigious Space Pioneer Award 2009. Dr. Annadurai has received many awards and honors. Notable among them are ISRO Team Excellence Award 2007, ISRO Merit Award 2009, ISRO Team Excellence Award 2010, ISRO Outstanding Achievement Award 2014, and many more yet. He has been awarded a prestigious Padma Shri 2016 for his contributions in the field of science and engineering by the Honorable President of India. And it gives me great pleasure to invite our guest of honor, Dr. Mylswamy Annadurai, Vice President, Tamil Nadu State Council of Science and Technology, to deliver the guest address.
Mr. Menas Alam IAS, today's chief guest, Dr. Sianandaram Krishnan, Director IAFT, Dr. Murali Krishna, Dr. R.T. Patil, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, my dear student friends and media. It really, really gives me an immense pleasure to be part of 50th anniversary of the institution as well as the founder director's memorial day here. It's really a panoramic view, as rightly brought us in here, inaugurating this particular hall and opening it up with his vibrant and dynamic welcome address. I think the way in which Sri Annadharamakrishnan brought in the welcome address itself indicates how a 50th year needs to be celebrated in an institution like this. When you're talking about 50 years, yes, one side we're looking back how, what we have done with a lot of thanks and gratitude. Yes, he has done it. While doing it, quantify, qualify the strengths and weaknesses of ours. Looking forward, what opportunities and threats we have, how our strengths, strengthening there, will make use of the threats as an opportunities, and how our weaknesses we can overcome so that in spite of the threats being there, along with our added effort, we will make convert these threats into opportunities. I think this is all about what we have done as space. Because you know, first two industrial revolutions, India was not part and parcel of it to use its fruits. Various reasons, either we are ruled by somebody else. Because of that, we are driven to a situation where our colleges were graduating the people meant for the clergy or administrative purposes for them. But after independence, yes, our science and technology has improved. To start with, our food security is brought in a major revolution thanks to people like Dr. Swaminathan. The green revolution has come, white revolution has come, wherein the milk product point of view, Dr. Kurian has done a revolutionary thing. Now beyond that, and look at here, gone are the days people are dying for starvation. Now as rightly Dr. C. Anandaramakrishna has told, food habits is creating a problem today, either in terms of obesity, or in terms of diabetics, or in terms of anemia. All many of the things, food is making us to anemia, food is making to diabetics, food is making to fatty. So this is another improvements happening there. And towards that, what overall food safety point of view the food processing industries can do? I think probably an outsider only, ringside we only can see that. And that provides ample opportunity of really, really what we can do. When we're talking about Industry 4.0 in all the technologies, starting from IT to space, yes, food technology also can do a lot. I could see the symbolically what he told about 3D printing. We are talking about 3D printing in a space and going to the Mars or Moon. I think rightly you are seeing a 3D printing, how it can come in the food processing industry. I think it's a really, really a remarkable thing. How this is what I'm trying to sell. When we are talking about the ongoing, the industrial revolution, something called Industry 4.0, every aspect of that, I think India cannot lag behind. I think that's what, when you're talking about, like our food security, space security also needs to be addressed. That's what Indian space program is concerned. Similarly, when you're talking about India is going to be the largest consumer of food grains. It's going to happen. And when it happens, definitely our food safety cannot lag behind. And the various facets of the food, definitely in the years to come, in the future is going to happen. So when looking beyond, when we are especially at this juncture, the institution like IAFT, looking back at this juncture and looking beyond, looking in the future, correctly bringing in the best of the best minds in that processing technology and trying to see, look forward, what India can do, not only for its own need, what is looking for the elsewhere available market potentials. This is what really needed today. And it is like this, it's happening there. So yes, Dr. Annadurai has told, many occasions, many places he invited me. For some reasons or other, I could not make it. This is like a wife, she cooks food. But she thinks she's doing well, but somehow husband is not taking the food. But somehow it's over persuasion, or way in which he's doing, finally he takes that food. And finally, yes, the taste is good. Similarly, I think he managed, I'm not telling he's my wife, I'm trying to tell him that the way in which he brought in here, and today the receipt of seeing this particular place, bringing the people like you, and the way in which he introduced each one of you from the food processing technology of the past, present, and possible futures, I think that way of looking at here. It's a really, really a very, very encouraging thing happening here. And the way in which from IAFT is coming out with the products, starting from onion processing, very many things keep happening there. And bringing how the nanotechnology can be used for food processing, it's really encouraging for the young minds to come in and being a part and parcel of this national effort. Probably it may become as a global effort in the years to come. And that way, the 50th year annual celebration, we are doing it here. I am trying to see it's multifaceted aspects of this particular celebration, and trying to showcase what are all the potential features available, opportunities available that will enable the young minds can be a part and parcel of the emerging food processing technology just in India, that can make the people to feel proud, not the feeling proud about we are going to the moon, finding a water on the moon, succeeding first attempt to making it to the Mars. And beyond that, I think this sort of efforts also need to be highlighted in a very, very better way, such that our food security, food safety for the huge mass of Indian populace, not only Indian populace, probably even the world market also will be able to do it. And towards that, people taking a pride of, yes, the entrepreneurships coming for the food processing technology, all the way taking even beyond food processing, is it possible to connect the chain, something called farmers entrepreneurship? That means farmer is able to do end to end, from the field to plate. Is it possible to have like that? Field to plate, is it possible farmer to take? So that farmers entrepreneurship comes in a big way, so that the chain of enabling the food processing technology enabling a possible scenario wherein the farmer from his field to the plate or to the fork, else we are talking about here, enable that to happen in the Indian context. We are able to do it. I think we have done an immense service to the farmers who are really feeding us. I think we are able to enable that. One side is trying to scale up what processing is there. Another side is coming to the scaling down to the level where the farmer can do this so that the value addition taking place. Right away, as Anandaramakrishnan has many places told, the onion industry, onion point of view, I think today Indian, specifically this side of the farmers are getting a benefit, a huge, huge benefit. I think they are able to get. And when they're seeing that in the similar thing happening for the other values also, it will definitely will add value to that. And towards that, I could see a good number of the upcoming topics for the food processing point of view. As a ringside view, when I'm looking at here, definitely this is what the need of the hour. When we're talking about from the field to the laboratories, land to lab, similarly going to lab to land. I think this is goes other way, land to lab, lab to land, it goes. And that way, an young and dynamic leader, say Anandaramakrishnan, at this juncture, probably thinking for next 50 years of IIFT, how it can be. And it's really, really a wonderful thing. And I'm happy to be part of this particular day along with you. And my best wishes, you grow a lot and have an IIFT flag flying high and high when the Indian processing technology is concerned. And someone has told, we have to create more IIFTs across India. Possibly more Anandaramakrishnans also in such as IIFTs. Not only for taking the needs of India, it is trying to address the possible global needs also. Even go beyond, even the needs of tomorrow's Moon and Mars also, probably we can address whatever, when talking about our own people going into space. Also, what really we can do, also we can think about that. So with all these things, my best wishes for all this great, great particular event is concerned. My best wishes to you, the organization, and the future scientists. Thank you very much.